Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss function expressions. I'm going to create a function expression for you, and I'm also going to copy a function expression to another variable that stores the action coming from the function expression. I'm also going to talk about the callback functions that use function expressions as the input. Finally, I'm going to talk about callback functions that use anonymous functions. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is so simple. I just contain the title and a heading. And this HTML file is connected to a JavaScript file stored in JS folder, and the file name is called myscript.js. So you can see that the file called index.html is stored separately. And inside the JS folder, I have a JavaScript file called myscript.js. Now let us go to the JavaScript file. In order to use the strict mode, I simply say use strict at the very beginning of the JavaScript file. And then let us start the discussion of function expressions. A function expression is something like that. In JavaScript, we can simply treat functions as an expression. In this way, we just assign a function to a variable, and a variable just stores the action coming from the function itself. And when we set up a function expression, we have to add a semicolon to indicate the end of the assignment statement of the function to a certain variable. So let us see an example. Okay, so this is the function expression. I set up a variable to indicate a function expression, and then I use function as the keyword, and after that I have a pair of curly brackets that specifies the thing that the function does. I just show an alert window by calling the variable shown here, and I have to stress that a semicolon has to be added at the end of the entire assignment statement of the function expression. So how can I just call the function expression? I can have a similar idea to what we do in calling a typical function. We just call the function using the parentheses, and we have to remember one thing for function expressions. A function expression can only be called after it is set up. Okay, and in function expressions, a function is regarded as a variable, and the variable has a value passed to it or has a value evaluated from the function. Okay, so let me just call the function expression. Okay, I just use a pair of parentheses. Before that, I just say the function expression variable. And let me save it and reload the page. Yes, you see, I'm able to set up the alert box according to the function expression definition, okay? So this is the way to call a certain function expression. And we have to remember that a function expression can only be called after it is set up. So when I just call the function expression, I have to set the definition of that function expression beforehand. This is something different from the function declaration that is another way of setting up a function in JavaScript. When we just create a function declaration, that function declaration can be placed below the function call. So this is something different from the function expression. In the function expression, we have to do the function definition before I can call it directly. Okay. Now, we are able to really show the code of a function expression. How can we do this? I can simply have an idea as follows. And let me try to show the code by using the alert window followed by the function expression name only. And we have to notice that no parentheses are added after the function name. So I just say func underscore expr. So let me save it and reload the page. Yes, I will have the alert window indicated by the function expression shown here. And after that, I'm able to show the function expression code in the alert window. Okay. So this is the way to show the function content by using the alert window. After that, I'm going to talk about the copying of a function expression to another variable. So I can do something like this to demonstrate the idea. Now I just copy the function expression to another variable called another function expression. So the idea is like this. I just copy the result of the function expression to another variable. So when I just call the variable again, I'm going to show the same effect as the original function. So let's see the result. Save. Reload. Yes. This is the alert window indicated by the function expression variable. And since I just copy the entire function result to another function expression, when I call another function expression variable, I'm going to show the alert box indicated by the original function expression variable. Okay. So this is the result of the copying action of a function expression to another function expression variable. After that, I'm going to talk about a callback function. A callback function is simply a function expression set up as a parameter of a certain function declaration. So let me type something to demonstrate the callback function. Now I set up a function called tellMeTime, and for the parameters of that function, there are two names called response1 and response2. And inside the function definition, I can say that for some particular condition, I will go to response1 function, and for other cases, I'll go to response2 function. But the functions called response1 and response2 are not yet defined inside the function definition. So how can I just make sure that the response1 and the response2 functions are set up properly? I can have an idea like this. Now, response1 and response2 are just the function expression variables that I'm going to pass to the tellMeTime function. And the exact content of response1 and response2 can be set up outside the function definition. So let me do the response1 and response2 functions below. Okay, I set up two functions called notLate and late. So these two functions are going to be passed to the tellMeTime function. So I'm going to use response1 and response2 as the function expressions that specify the notLate function and late function respectively. So when I just call the tellMeTime function by passing the notLate function and late function to the parameter list, I'm going to just treat response1 and response2 as function expressions indicating the two particular functions. So how can I do this? Let me show you now. Okay, when I want to call the tellMeTime function, I just pass notLate function and the late function as the parameters of the tellMeTime function. And you can see that I don't put parentheses after the function expression name. Okay, so these two functions are treated as function expressions indicated by response1 and response2 variables. And when I want to say that the time is less than 22, I just say that I'm going to call notLate function. Otherwise, I would call the late function. I can see the result right now by running it. Save. Reload. Yes, what time is it? For example, the time is now 13. Yes, you see, I will have the late function being called. So The responseTo function stores the value coming from the late function. So responseTo is the function expression indicating the late value. Okay, so I will say that you are getting too late in the form of an alert window. So let me run again. So how about the time is now 23? You see, when the time is 23, I will go to the second response called late function. So I'm going to show an alert window telling you that you are getting too late. Okay, so the late function is simply the function expression value represented by response 2. And I just pass response 1 and response 2 to the tell me time function as the arguments. Okay. Now I'm going to show you another example of the callback functions in the form of function expressions. Now this is the start of another function expression example that illustrates the callback function principle. Now I have a function called tellMeTemperature, and I'm going to have two parameters passed to the function. One is called notice1 and the other one is called notice2. And these two parameters are going to be represented in the form of function expressions. How can I do this for the example shown here? I'm going to use anonymous functions rather than the named functions as shown in the previous example. Okay. I don't use the names for them, I just use anonymous functions in this case. Now I have a function call in this way. I use the tellMeTemperature function and I just pass the two anonymous functions to the variables indicated by notice1 and notice2. So I just follow the order of the parameter list. Notice1 refers to the first anonymous function and notice2 refers to the second anonymous function. Okay, you can see that an anonymous function has no function name. So I just used function keyword and I don't include the function name. And since we use anonymous function, we can just use anonymous functions for some short function code only. For some larger content of the function definition, it is better to use the named functions instead of the anonymous function shown here. So when I call the tellMeTemperature function, I'm going to pass the first function, which is an anonymous one, to the first variable, and I'm going to pass the second function, which is an anonymous one, to the second variable of the parameter list. Okay, so let me try to save it first, and I'm going to run the code. The temperature now is, for example, 20 degrees Celsius. When I say 20, I'm going to just call notice1, which is represented by the anonymous function shown here, which is the first one according to the notice1 position of your parameter list. Okay, how about the other situation? When the temperature is now 28 degrees. Yes, I'm going to show the other function content. Temperature is too high. This is indicated by the second parameter of the parameter list of the tellMeTemperature function. So you can see that the function expression can be anonymous and it is suitable for some short function code only. Okay. So this video has already talked about so many things about function expressions. In general, we can simply treat a function expression as the value coming from a certain function, and we can just call the functions quite directly by calling the name, and we are also able to do the copying of the function expression to another variable. And when we talk about the callback function, we can simply put function expressions into a certain function as its parameters, and the parameters can be in the form of the named function or the anonymous functions. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.